For the dark hours when you dare not close your eyes.
No sleep.
It's the No Sleep Podcast.
No sleep.
Featuring stories from Reddit.com's No Sleep Forum.
No sleep.
Join us as the sleepless hours tick past.
Our next tale is entitled
This Is My House. Written by Erica Blair and read by Isla Chanuel.
I won't leave. This is my home. I dreamed about living here for years. This two-story house on the corner of Elk and Thomas Street. I saved for years to afford it, to move out of that cramped apartment with its moldy walls and the mixed stench of spoiled takeout and despair. And I'll be damned if I let this force me out. The incident started small enough a few months ago. Slammed door in the middle of the night, the television turning on when I wasn't in the room, items moving from their place on the coffee table or bookshelf. I tried not to let it bother me. I would carefully put those misplaced possessions back where they belong and ignore the sounds. I tried to avoid whatever caused the disturbances, but she was slender, dark hair and eyes, mid-20s as near as I could figure. She appeared all over the house, in the kitchen, the bathroom, the hallway. I could tell she could see me as well, and most times she would stand and stare at me, her eyes wide with fright and confusion, until I turned and walked away. Only once in a while would she flee or chase me. I thought, at first, that I might be able to handle her. After all, this was my dream house. I wasn't about to let her stop me from living here. But it just got worse and worse. I could hear her all the time. Talking, laughing, screaming, crying. Doors opened and closed all day. Water would run in the kitchen or bathrooms when I was in another room. One day, I went into my living room and all the furniture was rearranged. She would turn lights on or off, startling me. The girl began to scream at me whenever she appeared.
Just leave my house, get out.
I never responded. I didn't want to escalate the situation, so I would leave the room and leave her sobbing behind me. Now I don't know what to do. I'm not sure if I can live with this thing living in my house. This is my home, my house. But if I have to threaten her, I will. I'll shriek at her, chase her through the rooms with a knife if I have to. This is my house, and I'm not letting this supernatural bitch take it away from me. I don't care if I did die in my bathtub a year ago. This is still my damn house.